Continuation with the topic that we are discussing, insurance claims. We started the discussion, first I gave a general intro to what is the need for such a chapter called insurance. What is the need for a concept of insurance? Understood? We discussed that. So there was a need felt that business, when it is performing, it can focus only on the profits and loss that it has control over. There are certain losses for on which the business is not having any control, like the natural calamities. So any loss arising from natural calamities, accident on which the business doesn't have any control. So if the business is going to suffer loss because of such natural calamities, definitely businessman will not be interested in doing business only, correct? So there will always have an apprehension over the future, life and all. So if I want to be very confident of my business and if I want to trust my own skills, na, if anything happens to me other than my skills, then it has to be compensated. It has to be. That is how this concept of insurance developed, correct? Everybody floated by the government as a concept called insurance. Now what is insurance? Insurance is a contract between two parties called insurer and insured, whereby insurer agrees to compensate the loss suffered by the insured in return of consideration called premium. In a layman's approach, we pay something amount called a premium, and in return they make a promise to me that if I suffer any loss, that will be compensated to me, correct? Yes, in a layman's understanding. Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
There are two parties involved here, insurer. The moment you see insurer, you visualize whom? Insurance company. Insured? It is not person who takes insurance policy. There are so many people takes insurance policy for their household activities, household items that they may take insurance. We are not discussing that. We are discussing only the business enterprise. Correct? Then insurance of life, general of fire, marine, others. There are so many types of insurance are there. It is not which and all covered, which and all not covered. It is not like that. So many types of insurance. Burglary insurance, vehicle insurance, motor vehicle insurance, that insurance, this insurance. So many forms of insurance we have. Understood? Everybody. Everything will be coming under the head others. We don't want to expand this others and all. But broadly fire, marine and others. Correct? Two aspects in relation to insurance. One is accounting for insurance. Computations, various forms of computation, correct? In that, from a very, very wider angle of the chapter, we are just narrowing on to our syllabus. Understood? Our syllabus is very small. What is that we are going to learn? Insurer or insured?
Insured.
Life or general?
General.
In general?
Fire.
And in fire?
Computation.
What we compute? Computation of amount of loss. From the viewpoint of business enterprise in a fire insurance policy, in relation to a fire insurance policy. Is that clear?
Yes.
So we understand that a business enterprise having taken up a fire insurance policy, a business enterprise having taken up a fire insurance
policy
pays what?
Premium.
Whether premium matches with the insurance amount?
No,
premium is a very nominal amount you pay for a huge insurance amount. When I say I take insurance for 5 lakhs, I didn't pay 5 lakhs. I would have paid very less amount, correct? Maybe 3,000 rupees or 5,000 rupees to get an insurance cover for 5 lakhs. Understood? If I pay 5 lakhs and if I get back 5 lakhs, then there is no need for insurance. I will keep the money with myself. I pay only 3,000 and I get? That's a real gain for me. If suppose accident doesn't occur, then the 3,000 will be returned back to me?
No.
That won't happen. The 3,000 is lost forever, correct? Our 3,000 is a loss, no sir. Why I unnecessarily should take? Because it is a risk that you are covering. So for the risk coverage, you are just losing what? Somebody to give you guarantee that I will give you 5 lakhs. If you lose that amount, then for that you can lose how much? That 3,000 is a very petty amount when you compare to the risk coverage of how much?
5
lakhs. Could you appreciate that? So you pay what? Insurance company will give you cover. The total cover amount is called policy amount. It is called?
Policy
amount or sum insured or policy amount. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If there is an accident, then they will? compensate. They will compensate. Correct? We just made a discussion in the previous class that suppose I took an insurance policy. Business enterprise have taken an
insurance
policy. Fire insurance policy. Paid premium. After 2-3 months, there was a fire accident in our premises. There was a fire accident in our premises. Right? In that case, we may get some loss. So that loss, who will estimate? Is it the insurance company or is it the business?
Business.
What I lost, you know, I should tell, not you. Correct? You may verify it. You may investigate. You may allow it. You may disallow it. But I should tell my loss. Correct? I should intimate the insurance company about the occurrence of fire accident. And then I should also tell how much is the
loss
incurred. Could you appreciate that?
Yes.
Everybody.
Yes.
And thereby we are learning this computation from the viewpoint of insured. We are learning from the viewpoint of
insured.
Not from the viewpoint of
insurer.
Could you appreciate that?
Yes,
shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now listen carefully. So we are going to learn that computation of loss. Now when I say computation of loss, a fire accident will destroy what? What will you lose because of fire accident? What and all you will lose? Stock you will lose. Go down. Records. Money, cash, data, machineries, furniture, whatever you have in that place, everything may be destroyed. It is not only stock is getting destroyed. Our assets will be destroyed.
Yes,
furniture,
yes,
records,
yes,
everybody,
yes,
computer,
yes,
vehicle, human being.
Yes,
yes. Many things can be lost by fire. Above, we are going to learn. So loss of stock, loss of furniture, loss of various fixed assets, loss of human being. All these things we are not going to learn. So fire destroys so many things. Everybody,
yes,
already from a very wider concept, we already narrowed the topic. Now we are even more narrowing. We are going to learn only two types of loss. Loss of stock, loss of profit. Our topic is only loss of stock and loss of... So let us redefine the learning objective, what we are going to learn. Computation of amount of loss from the viewpoint of what loss? Loss of stock. Loss of profit. So we are going to learn two things only. One is loss of stock. The other one is loss of profit. So from this topic, we are going to learn only two things. One is called loss of stock. The other one is loss of profit. Is that clear? Everybody? Okay, now we are into the core part. First learning, computation of amount of loss. Rather than that amount of loss, let us fix the learning objective in a very different way. Up to the previous class, we learned in a very layman's approach. Let's fix that one more learning objective. That is learning objective in a redefined way. It is computation of claim for, I won't say the actual amount, we are just making computation of claim for. Because what we are computing is not only actual loss, we are computing what? Claim. So claim for loss of stock, loss of profit. Computation of claim for loss of stock and loss of profit in relation to fire insurance policy. In relation to fire insurance policy. So this is what we are going to learn. It is computation of claim for loss of stock, loss of profit in relation to what you can add is maybe from the viewpoint of insured, from the viewpoint of insured. This is our learning objective. Understood? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Please respond. The starting
yes,
good morning is not now again repeating. Everybody following?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us move into the very first item, which is claim for. It is not we are learning loss of stock, sir. What we are learning?
Claim
for loss of stock. Understood? So, claim for loss of stock. The first thing that we are going to learn is claim for loss of stock. Claim for loss of stock. Imagine you are all the insurance companies. I am the business enterprise in which there was a fire accident. I am going to make out a claim for loss of stock. So I am telling insurance company, you are all insurance company. Insurance company, in our premise there was a fire accident. Okay, sir. Now what can we do for you? I had a loss that you should compensate. Tell us, sir, how much your loss you are asking. Then I am telling my loss, how much I can tell? You are asking how much loss? 10 crores. Give me. You will give 10 crores, sir. So what is it you expect? It should be within the policy limit. Correct? It is well within the policy limit. You will give that amount? You will not give. So which means when I make out a claim, it should be having some justification, correct? I can't tell some numbers which I like the most. Could you appreciate that? Everybody, some of the friends says that, sir, I like the number 143. So thereby I will make the point, 1,43,000 is my claim. Like that, you can't make out some numbers. Every claim should be supported with some workings, correct?
Yes,
please respond.
Yes,
so when you are saying that, sir, this is the amount we want, then it should be supported with some working. You should justify why you are telling this number which you consider yourself as lost, correct?
Yes,
what do you say? Claim for?
Oh.
You are making a point that I have lost this much stock. Respond.
Yes,
how do I prove? I should prove first that this much stock I was having on the date of hire. If I prove that, then this is very easy, then you will accept it, correct?
Yes,
if I can prove that this is the stock I had on the date of hire, then definitely you will agree for the loss of stock, correct?
Yes,
so that means my first target is to prove you that how much stock we had on the date of. If I say that this is a stock, I'm of the fire accident occurred on 15th April 2014. When? I'm telling you, I'm giving you one statement. See the statement. In the statement, I'm showing that this is a stock I had on 15th. So I can easily tell this is a stock I have lost. Correct? So I have to prove that what is the stock I had on the date of fire accident. Could you appreciate that? Now, how do I prove the stock which I had on the date of? By giving you some statement, correct?
Yes,
now, in accounting, can you tell me which statement will have stock in it? There are so many statements. Now, which are the statements that you will have stock in it? Everybody? Trading account? Balance sheet account. So, there are so many accounting statements you come across. BRS is a statement. In BRS, you will have stock balance. Everything you should not tell. Yes, the BRS, the stock statement. BRS will have stock statement. BRS will not have stock information, sir. BRS is a statement. BRS is here. But it is not a stock statement. It will not have stock information at all. RL follow either. Okay, above not, that is not possible. Okay. Trial balance is a statement. Trial balance is a statement. Now, trial balance will have stock in it.
Yes, sir.
Trial balance will have stock in it.
Yes, sir.
Everybody.
Yes, sir.
Stock means trial balance as on 31st March, na, that stock as on 31st March should be there in trial balance.
Yes,
so closing stock normally is there in trial balance, correct?
Yes,
wrong. Closing stock normally never there in trial balance. Understood? I was asking a point whether the stock as on the date of trial balance is it there. Opening stock will be there.
Yes,
opening stock will be there, but not closing stock, not the stock which is existing on the date of trial balance. Please respond.
Yes,
so such stock, sometimes exceptional case it is rare, correct?
Yes,
but not always, everybody.
Yes,
so trial balance also will not have stock in it. Trading account is a statement or account? Trading account is a statement or account? Statement. Please understand, trading account is not an account, it is only a? You may title as account. I say, Jason and Co. is a company or not a company? Unco, not a company. Unco, I am an individual person. Can I use Unco? I can use. Are you following? These are all certain wordings which are giving misleading things. Jason and Co. business, correct? Is it company? Vasant and Co. Company or an individual? It's not company. Please understand. Unco, chumma. I am adding. Understood? There is nothing involved in it. It is simply added that particular word called an?
Co.
Could you appreciate that?
Yes,
please respond.
Yes,
so trading account is a statement or account?
Statement.
Statement. P&L account.
Statement.
Now henceforth, we will be learning in a separate format. Statement of profit and loss. We have just dispensed the usage of the term P&L account. We are going to call that as?
Statement,
statement of profit and loss. It's a statement. Could you appreciate that?
Yes,
now trading account will have stock in it.
Yes,
please respond.
Yes, sir.
Balance sheet will have stock in it.
Yes,
now I am going to prepare either of these two statements so that I can show how much stock I had on the date of hire, not some day stock. I am going to prove how much stock we had on the date of hire so that I can tell you easily that this is the stock I have lost, then you may accept.
Yes,
you'll accept what? This is the stock I had, so you'll accept the claim. Correct?
Yes,
are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Listening? The red shirt? Okay, fine. So we understand that it is, we are computing claim for?
Loss.
For that, you are asking, what is your claim? 1 crore. Justify. C statement. That statement is what we are discussing. Shall we?
Yes, sir.
So, what statement I can prepare? There are two statements involved. One is?
Trading
account. The other one is?
Balance
sheet. And moreover, how to extract that stock information means, if I prepare a statement, say a trading account. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Please respond.
Yes, sir.
In that, what are the information normally will come?
Opening
stock. Purchases. Expense,
sales,
closing stock, GP. Finally, will be arrived as balancing figure. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, opening stock represents, suppose trading account for the year ending 31st March 2013 means, this opening stock is as on what date? 1/4/2012. What is this stock? 31/3/2013. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then I will have purchase for the year 12/13. Expense for the year. Sales for the year. So that I will get gross profit. Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Now, here in the statement. Directly if I take the stock here, then the statement itself is not required. If I have some other basis for finding stock now, then the statement is not required. I am going to use the statement for finding closing stock, which means what I should do means somehow through some means I should find out opening stock. I should find out purchases. I should find out expenses. I should find out. I should also find out. And this will be arrived as balancing figure. I am proving you, this is my opening stock. This is the evidence. Oh, evidence is there. You accept it. Correct? Super. Opening stock ticked. This is my purchases. Evidence. Evidence. See ya? See evidence. Expenses. Everybody?
Yes,
sales. For all these things, I am providing justifications and you are accepting. Acceptable justification. Correct? Yes, just because of I am asking you to show this, see this evidence. Na? Seeing here, evidence is seeing. No, it should be justified. Evidence we'll be showing later, shall we? So that if you can arrive all this information, this will be arrived as balancing figure. So science students, please understand that in an account, a credit should be equal to? These are the items that comes in the trading account, everybody. Shall we proceed? In other words, it's actually a simple concept that opening stock plus purchase plus expense is the total value of the goods available. Total? From this, if I reduce the cost price of goods sold, from this I should reduce cost price of goods, I will get closing stock. This is a simple common sense approach. Correct? What is the common sense involved here? Though in an accounting format you are learning it, what is the common sense? Opening stock is the goods I have. Purchases, which I purchased during the year, is the total goods available?
Yes,
plus direct expenses, is the total value of the goods available? Total? From this, whatever I have sold, I should reduce, but at cost price. But sales will be given at? So from sales, you should reduce profit. From sales, you should reduce what? So opening stock plus purchase minus, plus expenses minus cost of goods sold. Correct? Respond. So thereby, what we are doing is, this GP to be reduced from what? Instead of reducing from sales, it is added in the left hand side. Correct? Still, it will give you same effect. So it is opening stock plus minus sales. Indirectly, reducing cost of goods sold. You will be getting closing stock. Everybody, this is a simple common sense approach. You are trying in the form of ledger account because you know the financial statement, trading account. Shall we proceed? Everybody, so thereby you are going to arrive at opening stock, purchases, sales, expenses, gross profit, so that you will arrive. Closing stock as balancing figure, taking these totals minus this amount, you will get the balance. Missing information, shall we proceed?
Yes,
this total should equal to this total. Based on that, this will be arrived as balancing figure. Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is another statement where stock will present?
Balance
sheet. Balance sheet as at 31st March 2013, which means I have say land and building, plant and machinery, furniture, stock, debtors, bills receivable, bank balance, cash balance. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Capital. Then you may have loans, creditors, bills payable, outstanding expenses, right? In this, if I can arrive these informations, if all these information can be computed, stock can be
balanced.
Clear?
Yes,
sir. So I have now two choices. What are the two choices? I am not directly teaching the chapter, but I am discussing from a layman's approach, a beginner to the chapter, creating how to solve the problem, correct?
Yes, sir.
It is not directly telling you, I know the solution, I know how to do, and I can easily tell, step 1, 2, 3, 4, now take down. That way I am not teaching you, we are just thinking from the layman's approach. We are a beginner, I am also a beginner, I am thinking, two choices is there, correct?
Yes, sir.
Two choice of statement is there, which statement? Which contains dash in it. So with the help of that statements only, we are going to show to the insurance company how much stock we had on the date of fire. Could you appreciate that? Logic behind it. Concept behind it. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. These two statements. In this, other things should be found out only then closing stock can be balancing figure. Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I decide to prepare what?
Trading
account should be prepared in such a way that the trading account is ending on the date of hire. insurance claims. Again, insurance claims. What is insurance? Blah, 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 discussion over. Types of insurance, blah, 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 discussion over. Learning objective, blah, 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 blah. Which one? What is learning objective? Computation of claim for loss of stock, loss of profit in a fire insurance policy. In that, claim for loss of stock. We are discussing on claim for in this we are telling. So as a businessman, when I make claim that saying this much stock I have lost, first I should prove how much stock we had. How much stock we had. Understanding on the date of? So that I can easily tell you how much stock we have lost. Sorry, how do I prove? I should prepare some statement. Which statement I can prepare? It comes to my mind so many statements. In that I scrutinize and took only two statements. Trading account? In trading account, if you can identify all other information except? So that closing stock can be? And he can easily tell you, see? This is a stock I had on the date of? Elampoch. Understood? That way I am easily going to explain you how much stock I have lost. Shall we?
Yes, sir.
When you prepare this trading account, it should be prepared in such a way that the period is ending on the date of hire. That period of trading account is ending on the date of hire. Could you appreciate that? Why should I prepare like that, sir? I will prepare year to year basis. Now, sir, closing stock is the balancing figure you are going to arrive. And objective of closing stock is to show that how much stock you had on the date of hire. Objective of closing stock is to show how much stock you had. Okay. Thereby, your trading account should end on the date of hire. Only then this closing stock represent. Because this is closing stock means, this is the year ending date. Please respond.
Yes,
closing stock, you know what you are taking here is exactly the stock which is representing at the end of the year in which, for which you are preparing the financial statement. Correct, Abba?
Yes,
everybody.
Yes,
so that way please understand, I have to prepare the trading account in such a way that is ending on the date of hire. Understood? You have about to have some confusion. Now you clear? So please understand, I have to prepare the trading account ending on? So then the stock that you arrive in the credit side, I won't say closing stock, the stock you arrive in the credit side is a stock which is exactly which was existing on the date of
fire.
Could you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
If this is a statement ending 30th June 2014, then closing stock is? 30th June 2014. This is a statement ending on 15th July 2014, then? This is 15th July 2014. So that way, if we want 15th July 2014, now your trading account should end on the date. Can explain logic behind every item. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Everybody.
Yes, sir.
And usually it commences from the beginning of the year. It commences. Not necessary, it should be 12 month statement. It is our convenient working only. This is a working sheet to know how much stock we had on the data file. It is not a statement to be reported to outsiders. It is an evidence we are creating to show how much stock we had on the data file. This statement can even for 10 days. This statement can cover even for a period of?
Yes.
It can even cover a period of 11 months. Understood?
Yes,
everybody.
Yes.
Not necessary that this trading account should be for a? 1 year. Could you appreciate? Respond. Suppose a fire occurred on 15th May 2014. 15th?
May.
And we prepare April to March as financial year now. Then this trading account covering which date to which date?
April 1st
April 2014. 15th May 2014. Is that clear? So the stock will be as on? 1st April 2014. This purchases? 1st April to 15th May. Correct? Expense? 1st April to 15th May. Sales? 1st April to 15th May. And GP on the sales? GP on this? Because GP means it is on the sales. Correct? So thereby you will get closing stock as balancing figure, which represents stock on 15th May 2014. Would you appreciate that?
Yes,
everybody.
Yes,
so if you decide to prepare trading account, then it should be for a period commencing from the beginning of the year in which fire occurred till the date of fire. It should be covering a period from the beginning of the year in which fire. First you see when fire occurred. Respond.
Yes, sir.
Also identify which year the fire occurred.
Yes,
then take the beginning of the year till the date of fire. Could you appreciate everybody? So trading account is prepared from the beginning of the year in which fire occurred till the date of fire. That the period also should be very important. Shall we proceed? Okay, and in that you will take all information except which will be arrived as, so that it is an evidence. See, all other information I gave you evidence. This is a balancing figure. So this is how I am proving that this is a stock I had
on the date of fire.
Is that clear? What is my next statement?
Balance
sheet. My next statement is balance sheet. So balance sheet should be dated. It's a point statement or a period statement?
Point
statement. So thereby my balance sheet should be exactly on the date of hire. Balance sheet should have assets and liabilities as on the date of hire. All my assets which are existing on the date of and all my liability existing on the date of, so that dash will be balancing figure. Stock will be balancing figure. Could you appreciate? Trading is a point statement or a period statement? Trading account is a
period
statement, but balance sheet is a and we also decided the periods now, correct?
Yes,
so if I prepare trading account, what period? If I prepare balance sheet, it should be exactly on. So the closing stock on the date of hire is balancing figure. Now you people, scholars, intelligent people, decide, should we go for trading account or balance sheet? Why? We need to select convenient items, correct? And here so many items, correct? Here we have less items. So thereby, anyway, I have to find out efforts. I should take efforts for finding many things. So I would like to have few items or more items?
Few
items. Is that clear? Everybody,
yes,
to reduce the ambiguity. Now we are all applying in a layman's common sense. Now we all easy things now. Correct? So thereby we will prefer what? Trading account or balance sheet? And now you only decide. So thereby we are not going to prepare this balance sheet and all. We are going to decide trading account. Understood? Everybody. So for proving how much stock we had on the date of fire, we are going to prepare a which is for the period from the beginning of the year in which fire occurred till the date of fire. Super. In which I will estimate all information, correct? And I will arrive dash as balancing figure. As balancing figure. Pakka? Everybody? Super. Now let us take one by one information. Opening stock. We have opening stock? Everybody? Okay. Now opening stock, from where I will take this information? Opening stock. Last year's balance sheet, last year's trading account, or last year's closing stock of previous year is the opening stock of current year. Is that clear? Everybody? Fire occurred in the current year? Response. So thereby we can take previous year balance sheet and tell how much is our opening stock. We can easily prove to the insurance company. But when fire occurs, it will destroy all the records or only current year records? It will destroy all the records. It won't tell fire is coming and fire is coming in the current year. Respond. Fire comes in the current year and saying, let us destroy only things of current year. Whatever relating to past, let us not touch and go like this. Like that fire will do. It will destroy all records. Appo, whatever balance sheet we had relating to previous are also destroyed. Achacho. Then what I should do now? My opening stock will be there with somebody else. That is my opening stock information. My balance sheet may be with somebody else. Now you have learned in your lower level, financial statements are prepared only for our own benefits or various users are there. internal users, external users, like that, so many things we discussed. Everybody. So our financial statements are there not only with us, it may be with somebody. Clear? So with whom it will be there? Shareholders, if it is company. Ilana? Creditors. Governments, government department, it could be with service tax department, income tax department, with financial institution, adu ellathiyum vida, with you people. Who are you? Chartered accountants. It will be with auditors. We are the people who conduct audit. So in the memory of that audit, na we are forced to maintain records of the company, correct? Right, whatever audit that we have concluded, the copy should be also there with
auditor.
Everywhere, somewhere, it may be income tax department, service tax department, or bank, or maybe with chartered accountant, or maybe with somebody, our financial statement is go and collect the financial statement. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So that way you can easily get the information. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then some students will say that, sir, balance sheet, I asked them to make questions to me. I told you in last class also. Apply your creative mindset and everything you ask question. And what student was asking is putting extraordinary creativity. One of the best student was asking, so I'm telling that opening stock and I can arrive from the balance sheet which is available with somebody. Correct? I tell that I can take it from my auditor. Then he's saying auditor place also fire. Then I will take from bank kaliyum fire. I can take from income tax department, angiyum fire. Hey, all the place fire, na insurance company fire. I told you, correct? So no loss, world they fire. I am also fire, I will kill you. So like that and all, you should not be making extraordinary creativity. Understood? So opening stock will be available somewhere. That is what you should understand. Clear? Next, what? Purchase and sales of previous year? No, purchase and sales of current period. This you can easily take from your accounting records. It can be taken from accounting records. Not necessary that you should be estimating and all. Correct?
Yes, sir.
But sir, fire destroyed everything. Bah. Whether fire came and tell, we'll destroy only stock, we'll destroy only furniture. This is accounting records department. Let us not go there. Let us take a U-turn and go to the other side. Whether fire will have a direction?
No.
If it is some English movie, the water, the wind, everything will have a direction. Are you following? So the lava, the fire, everything will have a direction. Suddenly, last moment that it will turn to the other side. That you can experience only in a movie, like English movie, you can see that. Understood? So all the dangers, they will have a direction. We can also change the direction. In a system, one button, suddenly last minute one button pressed, suddenly that will change the direction. All these things doesn't happen in a practical life. Could you appreciate that?
Yes, sir.
Upon what we do, we just find out that all such records were destroyed.
Yes,
we get the information from our suppliers. We get our information from our customers. Understood?
Yes,
we get our information from? When we bought the goods, we record purchase and they record?
Yes.
So our account is there with them. Correct? So we will get information from suppliers. We get information from our customers. What sort of purchase and sales we can get? Na? Generally, credit purchase and credit sales. Which purchase and credit sales?
Credit
purchases and credit sales. This is the information we can extract. So then cash sales and cash purchase, is there any possibility of extraction? If we have a system of depositing everyday cash into bank, most people will have. They won't accumulate the cash balance, correct? Most of the business will have. Collections will be deposited. Collections will be, maybe one day delay will be there, otherwise most of the collections will be deposited into
bank.
So from the bank statement, you can ascertain cash sales and credit sales. Sir, cash sales and cash purchases cannot be ascertained from suppliers and customers. So other people will maintain information about customer and suppliers only if it is credit. Understood? You go to a shop, you buy one pen. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
and you are telling that, say, I will pay the money later. Oh, creditor, tell me your name, tell me your address. Now, oh, you are the son of so and so person, okay, you pay me after 1 week. All records noted. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Oh, you are the son of so and so person. They are praising you and they are offering you credit. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
You are going to a shop. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
You are buying one pen and you are paying 10 rupees.
Yes.
He is taking 10 rupees. Then you are telling, sir, my name is Suresh. Oh, yeah, ni enna vanda enak enna. I am son of so and so person. So what? Get lost. So please understand, if it is cash sales, now nobody is interested in your name and address. Your entire records will be maintained only if it is credit purchase and sales. Again, common sense. Correct, Abba? No accounts I am teaching, sir. We are teaching only common sense. Accounts itself is common sense only. Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Everybody.
Yes,
sir. So we understand that. So we will have credit purchase and credit sales from? And cash sales and cash purchase from? Bank statement, or maybe it is estimated based on previous year trend. What previous year trend, sir? We always be having a proportion. This much credit sales, this much cash sales. From 2-3 years statement, we can arrive at the trend. Correct? So in this year, this is the credit sales and I found out. Respond. Last year when 1 lakh was credit sale, 50,000 was cash sales. Or this year credit sales was 3 lakhs now, cash sales might be? It's an estimated information. Would you appreciate that?
Yes, sir.
Everybody.
Yes, sir.
So opening stock, purchases and sales estimated.
Yes, sir.
Both cash sales?
Credit.
Estimated.
Yes, sir.
Now, this credit purchase and credit sale, from where you got the information?
Suppliers.
From suppliers and? There are two ways you can ask information from supplier. What are the two ways? One, supplier, during this period, how much goods I have bought from you? One information. Please respond.
Yes, sir.
The other way of information. Customer, today how much I have to pay you? Today? How much I have to pay you? Because if I ask him how much purchase I have made from you, if I ask him, there is a possibility that he may oversee it also. Everybody.
Yes,
so I am going to ask him in an indirect way. Hey, kindly confirm your owing, sir. Now tell me what is my owing, sir. As if it is a verification mode. Everybody.
Yes, sir.
Sir, but with that, how will you find out your purchases? I can, because I have complete records of payments to him. I have complete records of?
Yes.
I know what was the payable at the year beginning. Say 1 lakh is the payable at the? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
I know I have already paid 5 lakhs during the current year. I have already paid 5 lakhs during the? Using my bank statement, I got the information. Respond.
Yes,
if you can tell me how much is still payable, maybe 2 lakhs is still payable. Respond.
Yes,
which means I already paid.
Yes,
I am still payable.
Yes,
which means this is the total payable in relation to purchases.
Yes,
in that, I know opening payable from my previous year balance sheet.
Yes,
respond.
Yes,
which means current year I have purchased from him for 6 lakhs. I can find out that. Respond.
Yes,
so how I am finding that? I am just getting information. What information from him? Not the purchase information. I am getting what information? How much is still
payable.
So thereby it is a money paid plus
money
payable. Total amount is relation to purchases.
Yes, sir.
In that 1 lakh is relating to previous year purchases. Above balance is relating to current year purchases. Could you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
And this is called a creditors account. What account?
Creditors.
This is called opening balance. Buy balance. This is called closing balance. To balance.
Yes.
This is purchases. This is payment. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Respond.
Yes, sir.
So opening balance plus purchases minus payment is closing balance.
Yes, sir.
Once again. Plus purchases minus payment is closing balance. Everybody.
Yes, sir.
Now. When we go for computation, again these things will be explained. Now it's only visualization. Some students be feeling, oh, so many things are taught. It's only giving an overall outline. Pa. Then and there again we'll be discussing these areas. Everybody?
Yes,
so, but still, we like to get an overall idea also. You try to visualize that. So it is opening balance plus minus closing. But I don't know this, but I know all three. Which means it is payment plus closing payable. We'll give total payable. Minus opening payable, we'll give you. Current year purchases. Could you appreciate that? Either if this difficulty you don't want to do, nah, ask him, what is my purchases? You are not there. So you should ask what? Amount of purchases. Or indirectly like this, correct? In some form you will extract information from. In some form you will extract information from suppliers. Is that clear? Everybody? Pakka? Okay, that way we have the information about opening stock, purchases, sales. Expense is direct expense. Expense relation to purchase or sales or both? Expense relation to purchase or sales or both? Only purchases, not relation to sales. So a percentage of purchase is always generally expenses. It is always the carriage expense, transportation cost, wages and all. It is generally relating to what, sir? So thereby a percentage will again be considered as an estimated expenses, correct? Then gross profit. Gross profit we can find out not based on previous year. It is sales into gross profit ratio is gross profit. What is that?
Sales
into gross profit ratio. Every businessman knows his margin, correct? At what margin he sells, he knows. So thereby sales into gross profit ratio is the amount of gross profit. You should open your mouth. It is sales into gross profit ratio is the amount of gross profit. Are you following this? Everybody? So that way all information in the trading account over. Now you can balance that account. Arrive dash as balancing figure. Closing stock as balancing figure. Could you appreciate? Everybody, some of them are so experts, they feel that so many times you are teaching, I know it, sir. But some of them you are newly learning, so we need to bring a neutralized balance between that. Understood? If I am going fast, you can slow me, but if I am going slow, don't ask me to go fast. Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
So we are just ultimately targeting to show how much stock we had on the date of hire. How much stock we had on the date of
hire.
For that, we had two statements. What are the two statements?
Trading
accounts, balance sheet. In that we are just planning for? Because balance sheet will have kochana so many items, correct? So thereby we are planning for trading account with less items. Understood? So what is that? What are the items in trading account?
Opening
stock, purchases, expenses, sales, profit. So that we will arrive closing stock as? Opening stock will be arrived as an information from
previous
year statement. Purchase and sales,
suppliers
and customers. Spell. If you're not having the habit, suddenly you're trying to do the words will not come. So thereby purchase and sales from customers and suppliers. Expense estimated, correct? GP is dash into dash. Sales into gross profit ratio. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So then you will arrive closing stock as?
Yes,
balancing figure. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now listen carefully. That way we are finding out this closing stock. What is this closing stock representing? Stock on the
date
of hire. This is a stock on the date of hire. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Which is nothing but? Evidence. Stock destroyed by fire. Now I can say that this is a stock which we have lost, which is actually destroyed by
fire.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
So that way you should arrive at this information. What is GP? Sales into gross profit ratio. Pakka?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now listen. This stock represents stock on the
fire.
Now you are all the business people now. In your business place there was some fire accident. In your business place there was some fire accident. One person was not there in the class. You only said. Listen here. Show high hand, sir. Yes. Very good. Now you're actually not there in the class. Now you please come back to the class. Here, your attention should be, the body language has to be like this. Either screen or here, not down. Understood? Otherwise, I told you I will take revenge. I will curse you. You will become chartered accountant. And after you become chartered accountant, you will take a meeting or seminar for 1,000 people where I will be the first person showing like this. So that way you're supposed to listen to the class, right?
Yes,
and the smile poro. Very good, very good. So we are preparing. You are all the open your mouth, sir. You are all the business people. Business enterprise. Who are you? You are a businessman. Right? You are a billionaire businessman. Right?
Yes,
okay. Now in your business place, there is a
fire
accident. In your business place, there is a fire accident. What will you do? What will you do? Will you enjoy the fire? Wow! Will you enjoy that? I've never seen live fire. I used to see fire only in TV cinema. What a beautiful fire! Will you enjoy like this? What will you do? You will try to either put off the fire. Correct? You will fight against the fire. Understood? You will pour water, put mud, maybe the fire extinguishes. Hit the fire extinguishes. Understood? So like that, maybe pouring all these things, you take efforts to put off the fire, stop the fire. Clear?
Yes, sir.
But sometimes you won't do that because it has gone in an uncontrollable way. If it has gone uncontrollable way, then the next step what you should do is try to save something. Whatever you can save, save it. At least my water bottle I want to take, save, and I will run away. Are you following? So you will try to save something very precious, correct?
Yes, sir.
So generally a businessman try to save his stock. Try to save the
stock.
So during fire, some stock may be saved, which we call it a salvage value. What value?
Salvage
value. Salvage value means the stock which was saved or which is not destroyed. Fire, we just came and pawn with the butch. It just left the stock. Okay, pawn stock. Let us just say only 90% of stock. Let us leave something in a fire automatically put off. Understood? So some way stock was saved. Correct? Those stock saved in the event of fire accident is what we call it as. For which insurance need not give you money? How much your last one insurance should give you money? So thereby loss of stock equal to stock on the date of fire minus salvage value. The next step. We are into next step. Are you following this? Through this what you found out is not loss of stock. Through this step what you found out is stock on the date of fire. Insurance company, I had 5 lakhs. I have lost 5 lakhs. Then they will ask you, what is this stock there? Oh, this stock I have saved. Then balance is only what you have lost. Correct, Abba?
Yes,
so thereby stock on the date of?
Fire.
Stock on the date of?
Fire.
Minus?
Fire.
Salvage value. Minus?
Salvage.
Is called?
Loss
of stock. Could you appreciate that? Stock on the date of fire, you found out by preparing?
Trading
account. The next day what you found out is?
Salvage.
Not finding salvage value. Salvage value should be given. So you find out what, sir? Stock? Lost by fire, loss of stock. What you're finding in the trading account is stock on the date of fire. Stock existing on the date of fire. Correct? Then deduct. You will get stock lost by fire. Is that clear? Everybody. Now this is what we ask the insurance company to compensate. Is that clear? Suppose we find that we had 5 lakhs. How much?
Fire.
Stock on the
date of fire.
How much?
Fire.
5 lakhs. Salvage value 1 lakh. Salvage value?
Lakh.
You have insured for 7 lakhs. So taken a policy for?
7 lakhs.
Insurance now will give you totally
7
lakhs. insured for 7 lakhs? No. Unnecessarily I paid a premium, then you are supposed to insure for 7 lakhs. So fire accident came, give me 7 lakhs.
No.
No. What is insured they won't give you. They will give you only? Not even 5 lakhs. They will give only 4 lakhs. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So about 3 lakhs pocha. 3 lakhs is not going. What you have paid as premium only going. Correct? For the 7 lakhs you would have paid a premium of 7,000 or 5,000 rupees. Understood? Again, sir, you are getting an amount of 4 lakhs. Everybody.
Yes,
so thereby your claim will be to the extent of?
Last one.
Clear? In the same example. Everybody.
Yes,
insurance is only for 4,50,000. Insurance is for?
4,50,000.
In that case, they will give me 5 lakhs.
No.
They will give me 4,50,000.
No.
They will give me? Not even 4 lakhs is what we are going to explain to you next. They won't give you even 4 lakhs. They won't give you even 4 lakhs. So why say they won't give 4 lakhs? Because the stock existing on the date of hire was how much? But you took policy only for? This is the second problem, sir. Not 7 lakhs. You took policy only for? When the stock with you was 5 lakhs and you took policy only for?
4 lakhs.
Which means you have taken the policy for lesser amount. You have taken the policy for? Which means you were ready to bear the risk for 50,000. You were ready to bear the risk for? And you passed on the risk to the? You passed on the risk to the insurer only for? Which is 90% of the total stock. Correct? Respond. 10% risk you are ready to bear? So, since you are underinsured, we will discourage this policy and thereby when your claim was 4 lakhs, in a claim for?
4 lakhs.
Even though you are insured for 450, which is more than the loss, this amount may be more than the loss. This is more than the
loss.
But I won't give you 4 lakh 50. I won't give 4 lakhs. I will give you 4 lakhs into in a proportion. What proportion? Na? When the stock was?
5 lakhs.
You insured only? In this proportion only, I will give you this claim. In which means you took the policy for 90%, I will give you the claim also only for 90%. Understood? So thereby how much I will give?
3,60,000.
Could you appreciate that?
Yes, sir.
Everybody.
Yes, sir.
So thereby, first you should find out stock lost by
fire.
What is stock lost by fire? Stock on the date of fire. Minus salvage value. Stock on the date of hire minus salvage value. Could you appreciate that? That is called loss of stock. Loss of stock. Then claim for loss of stock. For claim for loss of stock, we'll apply a proportion. We will? This is called application of average clause. This is called? Slowly, steadily, I am introducing technical language from a layman's approach. Correct? We were in the process of learning the concept in a layman's approach. Now we are introducing some technical concept. We'll apply something called what class?
Average
class. Why should I apply average class? To discourage dash under insurance. If the stock is 5 lakhs, I expected you to insure for
5
lakhs. If you are insuring less than, then I will not give claim in full. I will give in a proportion. What proportion I am applying? That average class, okay, but what amount by what amount? 4,50,000 by 5 lakhs is okay, but how you learn that 4,50,000 is what? The 4,50,000 is what? Policy amount. You are not listening. 4,50,000 is what? What is 5 lakhs? 5 lakhs is not loss. 5 lakhs is? Stock on the date of hire. Understood? So ultimately claim equal to dash into dash by dash. Loss of stock into policy amount by stock on date of hire. Is that clear? Everybody? So it is this way. Once again, claim equal to dash into dash by dash.
Loss of stock
into. In our class, we will have lots of times use the term dash and all. This is not the dash what you are using at your level, correct? So please don't compare both the dash, because I have seen that today's the present generation, bad words and all, it is only dash, not even expressing bad words. Anything getting angry, na put a dash. So now it is convenient, in the dash anything can be filled, correct? So anything extreme or anything lesser level, any weightage can be added to the dash. So that it becomes so simple now. Understood? If I want to scold somebody, put that dash. That's all. Understand? Everybody. Yes, so thereby that dash is not we are telling here. Here dash is the real meaning of certain words. Everybody?
Yes,
so once again, claim for loss of stock equal to?
Loss
of stock into? Policy amount by? Stock on the? Date of fire. Understood? Loss of stock equal to dash minus dash. Stock on date of fire minus salvage value. Understood? Stock on date of fire will be find out by preparing dash. Trading account. From the dash of the year to the dash of the year. Beginning of the year in which? Fire occurred. Not in summer, any year. It should be beginning of the year in which? Fire occurred till the date of fire. Suppose fire occurred on 10th February 2014. Then 1st April 2013. So generally the year means it's a financial year. Unless they express in a different way. If the expression is different, you can take from January. But here it is. Generally it is April to March. Correct? So 10th February 2014 fire accident. 1st April 2013 to 10th February 2014, correct? Everybody, this is how we take up this particular trading account, and in the trading account we will get dash as balancing figure. Closing stock as balancing figure, which is representing stock on the date of fire. Stock on the date of fire minus will give you loss of stock into policy amount by. Understood? Now this average class, this percentage is called what?
Average.
Will be applicable only if it is underinsured. Suppose it was overinsured, means it is not applicable. In that case, what will be a claim?
Actual loss.
Loss also 4 lakhs, claim also 4 lakhs. Correct? Don't apply percentage here. If you apply percentage, what happened? 4 lakhs into 7 lakhs by 5 lakhs. Which is more than the loss, correct? Never you will be getting more than the loss. Could you appreciate? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
So these are the points you should be knowing. So these are the things that we are just expected to learn, shall we?
Yes.
Personally, we understand loss of stock equal to dash minus dash. Salvage value. Understood? Claim for loss of stock, if it is underinsured, apply average class. If it is not underinsured, Actual loss equal to? So average class is applicable only if it is
underinsured.
Average class is applicable only if it is average class, means applying this proportion is called average class. Is that clear? Pakka? Lots of theories are there. So let us do one problem and then come back to the theory discussion later. I would like to dictate detailed notes for this, whatever we discussed so far. Shall we?
Yes, sir.
So all these things I will do later. Presently, we like to do one problem. Question number one. It is, compute claim for loss of stock in each of the following cases. Rupees are in thousands. Which means what is written here is not merely 200, it is?
2 lakhs,
40,000, 2,50,000, right? Rupees are in thousands. Particulars A, B, C, D, E, F, G, which means how many problems?
Seven
different problems. Understood? Now, what and all I have given? Stock on the. From this, you will get what?
Loss of
stock. Then, you should decide average class is applicable. Further, you should provide justification. You should not simply say not applicable or applicable or not. You should say this is more than that, thereby not applicable. This is less than this, thereby
applicable.
applicable. Then you should apply the formula and get the policy amount. I'm sorry, get the claim amount. Everybody? So I want you to do in a detailed step. When it is for 4 marks question comes now, I don't want you to get 1 mark even though your answer is correct. Understood? So thereby, I don't want any one of you to write in 2 steps just making out the computation how answer should be presented first. Loss of stock equal to. No, don't copy. What you should write?
Stock on data,
stock on data fire minus salvage value. That is 2 lakhs minus 40,000 equal to 1,60,000. Then next step. This amount is more than that or this amount is less than this. Therefore, average clause applicable or like that you should provide justification. Respond.
Yes,
then claim equal to this amount into this amount by this amount. Like that you should provide answer. Clear? Everybody, for each question I want you to write in full. I will check every one of your notebook here and there coming, sir. I will ask you to pass on the notebook and see. I want you to have full writing. What is the writing first step? Loss of stock formula you should write. Then you should write amount. Amount wise difference. Correct? Then you get loss of stock. Then first loss of stock formula pass. Stock on data fire minus salvage. Then amount minus amount. Correct? Then you will see whether average clause applicable or why it is applicable or not applicable. You should see. Understood? If it is underinsured only it is. If it is not underinsured, not applicable. Correct? That you should write. Everybody. Then you will write the computation and show the final answer. Understood? I don't want you to use simply the calculator and write the answer alone. I want you to write in full. You need not take the question at all because it will be there in your handout that will be given. Correct? Just looking at the question, you can just proceed with the answers, computations and answers. Case A. First step. Loss of stock equal to stock on date of hire rupees 2 lakhs minus 40,000 equal to 1,60,000. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Then policy amount of rupees 2,50,000. Policy amount, you are supposed to write in full. Policy amount of 2,50,000 is greater than stock on date of fire, which is actually how much? 2 lakhs. Therefore, average clause not applicable. It is not merely mentioning it. This is only loss of stock. Then student is expected to write claim will be the actual loss. That is 1,60,000. For case B. $360, $60, $240 numbers. So once again, loss of stock equal to stock on the data fire minus that you should write. I am not writing. Can I take that license?
Yes, sir.
I am not writing. So imagine in each and every independent problem it should have been written. So let me take that issue. It is 3,60,000 minus 60,000, we will get 3 lakhs. Policy amount is 240. Policy amount of 240 is less. You need to write like same statement and all. It could be some other statement giving the correct meaning. Understood? Not exactly word, the same word what I use here. In your own words, you explain. That's sufficient. Understood? So policy amount of 2,40,000 is less than stock on the date of fire. Therefore, average clause is applicable. So claim equal to loss of stock into policy amount by stock on date of fire. That is 3 lakhs into 2,40,000 by 3,60,000. 2 lakhs. This is the answer for case B. Case C. In case C, we have loss of stock equal to five lakh minus 1 lakh equal to 4 lakhs. So loss of stock over. Policy amount of rupees 5 lakhs is equal to stock on date of fire. Therefore, average clause not applicable. Only if it is under insured. Equal insurance also not applicable. Over insurance not applicable. Only if it is under insurance it is applicable. Average clause not applicable. So claim will be equal to actual loss. That is 4 lakhs. Is the answer to case C. For case D, it is 600, 120, 480. Okay. Loss of stock equal to 6 lakhs. If a student have written only in thousands, writing 600, then also no problem. Not necessary, you should write in full and all. Understood? 600, 480, that way also you can present. But you should have written rupees in thousands. At the top, somewhere you should have written rupees in thousands. Okay, 6 lakhs minus 1,20,000. It is 4,80,000. Everybody, loss of stock is 4,80,000. Now proceeding, loss of stock equal to 6 lakhs minus 1,20,000. It is 4,80,000. Now policy amount. Can I take this page? Okay, copying time later. So policy amount 4 lakh is less than stock on date of hire. Now one thing you should compare or what you should learn from this computation is that never you should compare the policy amount with loss. You should not compare policy amount with loss. You should compare policy amount with stock on the date of hire. Would you appreciate that? So thereby it is, therefore, average clause is applicable. So thereby claim equal to, directly I am not writing formula, loss of stock. How much is loss of stock? 4,80,000 into 4,80,000 divided by 6 lakhs. 3,84,000. Case E. In case E, 800, 150, 720. Loss of stock equal to loss of stock equal to dash minus dash 8 lakhs minus 1,50,000 equal to 6,50,000 loss of stock. What is the policy amount? Policy amount 7,20,000. Policy amount is 7,20,000. Correct? 7,20,000 is much more than. No, it is more than loss of stock. It is more than. So no under insurance, huh? Under insurance is there, sir. Because you should not compare policy amount with loss. You should compare policy amount with stock. Based on loss, nobody take insurance. Based on stock that you have, only insurance should be taken. Correct? So thereby, I don't see whether your policy is more or policy is less. Clear? So thereby, what we should do is that we should take policy amount. How much? 7,20,000. Policy amount is 7,20,000 is less than stock on date of hire. How much? 8 lakhs. Therefore, average clause applicable. So claim equal to loss of stock 6,50,000 into 7,20,000 by 8 lakhs. 5,85,000. Super. All the combinations of average clause is what we are learning through this problem, right? Here in after there is no other combination you will be having. These are the maximum combination we are having, case F. So in case of case F, we find loss of stock equal to 4,50,000 minus nil 4,50,000. Everybody. Which means what? Salvage value nil means what? Whatever stock we had is fully destroyed. Whatever stock we had fully destroyed. Here also you may apply the concept of average clause or not. But I have one other principle. I have a shortcut principle. Even if you apply average clause, I don't have any issue. You apply and decide the answer, still you will get same answer. Everybody? But another principle, another shortcut is that if there is no average clause, then claim will be stock on date of hire or policy amount, whichever is less. Claim will be stock on the date of hire or policy amount, whichever is less. Everybody. So in this case, what is stock on the date of hire? 4,50,000. My dear friend, your friend is sleeping. Listen, come back to class. So stock on the date of hire is 4,50,000. Understood? Okay. So stock on the date of hire 4,50,000, and salvage value is, so loss of stock equal to 4,50,000 minus nil. Everybody? In such problem where salvage value is dash or dash, whichever is less, is the claim. Or policy amount. What is policy amount here? So thereby claim is 3,50,000. Claim is? Now this you will get even if you apply average clause. You find 3,50,000 is less than the stock. You will apply average clause. Average clause will be loss of stock 4,50,000 into 3,50,000 by 4,50,000. You will get 3,50,000 as answer. With that way you get 350, or without applying average clause also it's okay. So whenever you get salvage value, When the salvage value is nil, then claim will be as policy amount is less than stock on date of fire and salvage value is nil, claim will be restricted to policy amount, that is 3,50,000. Claim will be restricted to policy amount. Ultimately answer is 350. Even if you apply average class and you got the answer is 3,50,000, that is fine only, right? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Next, you have case G. Case G. What is that? Loss of stock equal to 7 lakhs. As salvage value is nil. Policy amount is 7,50,000. So claim equal to 7 lakhs. Whichever is less. All other steps we have only if there is salvage value. If there is no salvage value, claim is very simple. It is only to the extent of 7 lakhs. Understood? Whatever you claim, not necessary to be accepted by insurance companies. So what if I overstate, sir? What if I, first of all, as I first respect you, you are all experts of computation of claim. You should respect the insurance company. They are also the experts. They will conduct adequate study. They will see whether you are making any fraudulent claims or not. And accordingly, they will make out the claims. Understood? So, in any form of crime, don't now bring out doubts in the class. Crime in the sense you are trying to do some fraudulent claims. Understanding as what if I show this much profit, I was having this much profit, like that if I demonstrate, na, everything will be verified. Verification, it is not like your schoolish or childish level. They are all the experts who can play with numbers with a wide experience and expertise. Understood? So thereby, do not make accounting doubts, or in any accounting class, do not bring the doubts of crime. Understand? So you are making fraud. What you will do now, sir? Understood? So what sort of doubts you should be getting is, sir, what is the accounting? This is not accounted. This is accounted. This is more. This is less. That way. Do not bring out, sir, what if I do wrongly? Understood? So then they will know how to accordingly find out. Understanding? So those things can't be raised. Any other things? This is crime because you know very well this stock is not there with you. Correct? So thereby you should be not disclosing. If you disclose also, they will find out. Either in salvage value. They will notice your stock maybe 1 or 2 days later. The stock will come. They will notice it. Definitely all things. Later on also, if they give claim, later on also they know now, they will file a case against you for making fraudulent claims. So something like that will happen. Understood? Fine. Which chapter we are discussing? Insurance claims. We started the discussion from the insurance chapter viewpoint. We discussed what is insurance. Correct? Insurance is a contract between called insurer and insured, whereby insurer agrees to compensate the loss suffered by insured in return of consideration called premium. Fine, that is over. Correct? Two parties, insurer, insured. Two business, life, general. General into fire, marine, others. Two aspects, lots of losses. Correct? In that learning objective, computation of claim for loss of stock, loss of profit in a fire insurance policy from the viewpoint of insured. Claim for. First, I should find out the stock existing. On the date of. By preparing. Trading account. By preparing. Until you spell the trading account, I will repeat several times. So it is preparing. The trading account will be prepared for a period commencing from beginning of the year in which fire occurred till the date of fire. Correct? It will be prepared from the beginning of the year in which fire occurred till the date of fire. Understood? In that we will take opening stock, purchases, sales, GP will be balancing. Opening stock from last year's statement. Purchase and sales. Either directly or indirectly. Either direct information. How much is my purchases or indirectly? What is the amount payable to you? Now you tell me that, then I have opening balance, I have the payment. With that I will find out the purchases. Right?
Yes, sir.
Cash purchase and cash sales either from bank statement or estimated. Cash expenses, direct expenses, estimated. GP is sales into gross profit ratio. You will get GP. So that dash is balancing figure. We selected trading account, not balance sheet, because balance sheet have lots of items and trading will have few items. So that's why we thought of estimating few items. Right?
Yes,
and then we will find out the stock lost by fire. Stock lost by fire equal to dash minus dash. Stock on the date of fire minus salvage value. Right? Then we will see average clause applicable if the policy amount is less, underinsured. Then average clause applicable. Otherwise, not applicable. Understood? And then if average clause is applicable, if average clause is applicable, then loss of stock into policy amount divided by stock on date of fire. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Gross profit ratio is something to be given in the question, because it is known to whom? Business. But sometimes it may not be known. It may not be?
No.
I don't know what margin and all. I simply keep selling. I don't know my margin and all. Understood? In that case, we will help him to find out his trading account. Understood? We will help the person to find out his gross profit ratio. So how means? By preparing trading account of previous year. By preparing? He will have information about previous year. With previous year financial statement available with somebody. So we will prepare trading account of previous year. Opening stock available,
yes,
purchase available,
yes,
sales available,
yes,
closing stock available. Available, because it is previous year statement. Previous year all information available, correct? We'll arrive GPS balancing figure. We'll arrive. Then we'll find out GPR, which is GP by sales into 100. What is GPR? GP by sales into 100. Thus, this topic will revolve around, or this topic is sequenced into four steps. Identification of GPR. Because to prepare trading account for finding the stock on the date of, we need GPR.
Yes,
GPR means gross profit ratio. First, you should know what is. It may be given. Given now only three steps. Not given means? So thereby, if GPR given, well and good. If GPR not given, fine. By preparing trading account of previous year. Then prepare current day trading account to find out stock on the date of minus. You will get. And then claim by applying average clause or not. Understood? In fact, still I have not given detailed notes for this. I will have to dictate around 15-20 minutes. Notes alone we would like to have in four steps. Everybody?